Okay, let's talk a bit about Kyushu first. You know, there are various people who try and explain Kyushu using the Chinese concept of the meridians, the energy channels. And you know that Kyushu exists in various points around the body. But there are some people whose constitution is such that even if you strike them in this point, it won't work. And you've also got to understand the principle that if you dissect people, you'll find that there are great differences in people's anatomies. So even when you're attacking Kyushu, you've got to be able to produce variations. There's got to be a flow to it. For example, taking a wrist lock or any form of lock like this is also a form of Kyushu. So it's necessary in techniques to be able to get Kyushu and arm locks, wrist locks and so on at the same time. So you can be touching two Kyushu actually as you bring the wrist lock on. And if you miss one of them, you can take the thumb instead. And many of the meridians are also extending from the thumb up the arm, so in a way it is a Kyushu too. So there are sometimes where techniques like this will not work because they have a lot of power in their arms. And even if you don't strike hard into the Kyushu, just a slight touch in there will enable you to put a technique on. And it's also very important to be able to decide things within a space to fix them. You can see the sensei is controlling his legs too. If he wants, he can move like this and Arno can't respond at all. And if he had some swords or other weapons, he could use them more freely. You're striking in a way that he doesn't see what's coming. See how his knee's striking Arno's knee too.
1, 2, 3
points.
Okay.
And you do this in such a way that he doesn't know what's happening. Sensei, did you notice that the elbow was also going there? We'll do it a bit slower. You look as though you're trying to run away from them. Then you strike with the elbow too. It's kind of strike that even the people around the outside won't notice. You can't focus on any point. It's like cutting through some sort of space. And this is what ki is about. Everybody tends to focus in on individual points. It should become more like the wind. Move in like the wind. Everything's moving in at the same time, going in with the whole body.
Okay.
There are 4 strikes.
Okay.
But they should all be done in a way that he doesn't know what's happening. You understand? And you might have variations like this. Once you're in this space, you can create as many variations as you like.
Okay.
Try this one. And you roll with them.
Yeah.
He's capable enough to have been just outside the range. But, But if you don't avoid it, then you get a head on, you get a foot on your head. This is what a real ukemi should be like. Takes you out of the way. If you just did that kind of ukemi, then you'd be done for. Ukemi too must be alive, they must keep moving. Otherwise you end up as just being a target. Now, try up to here. What happens if you miss? And if you're going to roll away, then you can put in a strike to Akusho as you roll over them. Okay, he tries to take Omoto Gyaku. You move around here and control him. Behind him. That's if he tries to put Omoto Gyaku on you. Alternatively. There's another thing that he won't know what's coming there. You just grab one finger. It's important to escape with your legs. Learn to use your whole body and to move with it. Learn to move your whole body. Don't let the opponent put some force in there. Make him think that you're letting him take the technique, but don't let him. You've got to have this sort of free space within you. Okay, let's deal with a few small points, a few details. Tips of the fingers first, that's a small point. You let him grab it and then you move in with him.
Okay.
You move with him.
Okay.
You do this with your legs. You move in with your legs to move your hand. Watch. Since it doesn't go too far beyond this, because it can be dangerous, but... Since you do it this way round, because doing it this way would be too dangerous. But if you went like this, they wouldn't be able to get any breath. You move in with your leg. It's with your leg that you do the action. Take both sides of the lapel. Because he's going to put his hand there to try and take you. And you take him back in return. But remember to use your legs. So with koppo, as you bring them down, you control them in other ways. You don't let them escape.
Okay.
He can't move. This can be very painful.
Okay.
Don't let them escape.
相手の手を取るんでも胸を取るんでもね、やっぱりこう取るんでもそれで
も。And even if you're grabbing their hand or their chest or whatever, you can grab in various different ways.
Okay.
Instead of just grabbing the clothes, you can grab their muscles instead and hold them there. And if he lifts his hand up, then you can use that too.
Okay.
That's the flow of it. You've got to use your whole body to control them there. There's also a bit of deception as you move in. And always keep control at the end. This should be just a habit of yours.
So,
hands, legs, it's the whole body. Since they're sure that a lot of people have seen Daisho Sabaki on the videos, so we'll do a couple of techniques. Now, so Sensei's about to draw his sword and the other guy tries to stop him. That's the first thing to learn. If he's coming in to try and stop the sword being drawn, then you can actually strike him with the hilt. Not many people have bought Bokken, right? Do you understand? You've got to use it in combination with your taijutsu. If Sensei does too many, he's sure that people might get a bit confused. So now it's the reverse situation. And this time you deliberately miss the sword he thought you were aiming for and go for the other one. It hurts a lot if you actually keep it inside there. That's why you let it go. So in martial arts, there's always omote and ura. There's always the front side and the back side. Sensei tries to grab it, and so John tries to hit that. It doesn't matter if he actually does. It's like a puzzle. Can you move?
Okay.
Many different movements. You avoid with your body. Doesn't matter if you let them take it. Because you can use your taijutsu. Since they're sure it's not that much fun for people if you don't have weapons yourselves to try it out with.
Yeah.
Unless you want to see more. What do you prefer? There are many different ways of drawing the sword too, using your legs. So these are many different ways of EI too.
Okay.
Peter? Yeah, Sensei thinks that, you know, it's maybe about time, or not?
Yeah.
Right, yeah, arigatou gozaimasu. Okay, let's continue all of this at the Taikai then.
Okay, thank you.
どんどん警察のためにまず感謝の意を表したいと思いますので、それでそれを表してこれを差し上げたいと思います。はい。